and welcome to today's live IELTS class. My name is Adrian, and I'm streaming to you from beautiful Budapest. I hope everybody is having a good and healthy weekend. Hi, Abhishek, Sammy, Jainil, Hina, Samuel, Beckjan, and Carolina. Good to see many of our members in this class. While we wait for a few more of your members, this class is brought to you by aehelp.com for academic IELTS success. Please visit us there and check out our packages. And for general IELTS, visit us at gieltshelp.com and check out our premium packages there. I'll quickly show you these websites while we wait for a few more of the members to join in. Welcome all of our viewers as well. This is our academic website here with the blue background. Click that big red button to join the premium package. And for the general version, it's the green background, and you can click that big red button to join us there. Okay, everyone. So today we're looking at speaking part two, which is the cue card. We'll talk about how to get more bands, what you can do. And we also uploaded a brand new speaking interview video with a candidate from India with Kiara. Did everybody have a chance to check out that HD video with video lesson? It's kind of an interesting one. Kiara is obviously a very advanced English speaker, but she's a little bit uncertain of herself. Sammy says, yeah, I've seen that one. It's good. There's actually some really nice language in there. So Kiara is actually using some really nice, natural English. And yeah, it might seem like some of what she's saying isn't perfect, but you can tell that she's quite comfortable with the language. So definitely a good video to take a look at. All right. Carolina has seen it too. That's great. If anybody has questions, you can always send me an email to adrian@aehelp.com, and I will happily answer that. Of course, remember, everyone, that you have free speaking practice with other IELTS students like Skype or WhatsApp on our website. So make sure you use that speaking function on the websites. Is everybody using that? Carolina, have you had a chance to check out that speaking, student partner speaking function on the website? I know a couple of people. I think Ashraf is using that quite regularly, so that's good. Okay, cool. Yeah, so hang in there, everyone, when you go to that web page, and be confident. Just click and text others and let them know, hey, let's speak, let's practice at least a part one, just a few questions. All right, Abhishek says, yeah, I use it. It's good. Hina couldn't connect. All right, Hina, you might have to use a VPN, Hina. So some countries, they set national limits on chat software, so you might have to use a VPN, Hina, to circumvent that. Okay, cool. So today, speaking part two and speaking part three. So everybody who's watching, we will have an all chat class that will be speaking part three, where everybody will be able to join the chat, and that will be connected to this class, speaking part two. Okay. All right, students, it is a speaking class, so make sure to speak and repeat. Whenever I say these sentences, new words, phrases, repeat. All right, so make sure to do that. Okay, I'm using, or I'm speaking with a West Coast Canadian accent. I'm from Victoria, close to Vancouver, Seattle. People in San Francisco, Los Angeles, San Diego, they speak with a similar accent to myself. Maybe some slight differences, but mostly we're all kind of the same. We're also very similar, by the way, to East Coast. So if you ever wondered, students, about accents in North America, strangely, East Coast and West Coast accents, so somebody from New York and somebody from Vancouver, have somewhat similar accents in many parts. Of course, there are some differences, even locally in New York, but there's a lot of similarities between Toronto, Vancouver, Toronto, Los Angeles, and so on. Okay, anyway, let's get to this cue card here. So this is a part two cue card. So this comes about 5-6 minutes into your speaking interview. Okay, the examiner will say, that is the end of part one. Now we will continue with part two. For part two, here's a card with some questions. Here's some notepaper and a pencil. You will have 1 minute to look at the questions, think about your answers, and then you will have 2 minutes to speak. I will tell you when to start, when to stop. Let's begin. Turn over the card. Your 1 minute preparation time begins now. So you turn over the card, and this is what you see. What's your first step? Okay. What is your first step when you turn over your card? And I know a lot of people will be doing their IELTS exams this week and the next and over the next few weeks, catching up after COVID. So really important steps here. So you turn over that card. What is your step number one after you turn over the card? And it's actually really important. So these steps here that you're doing in this 1 minute preparation time is extremely important. I think a lot of students or a lot of candidates don't actually realize how important this 1 minute is, okay? The reason this 1 minute is so important, because it will have a major impact on your part two cue card response, the way that you plan your answer. And it will also have a major impact on your part three, because part three is connected to part two. So if you do really well in part two, you're going to do better in part three. And to do well in part two, you have to use that 1 minute really well. So my opinion is that the 1 minute preparation time in part two is the most important minute of the speaking interview. Is everybody clear on what I just said there? I think that's kind of an idea that we never discussed, and it's worth noting, absolutely, okay? So definitely I would argue, if somebody said during the whole speaking interview, what's the most important 1 minute? Ironically, it's the 1 minute where you're not actually speaking, okay? Of course, life is full of irony, right? So ironically, the most important 1 minute in the 15-minute interview is your 1 minute preparation time in part two. Okay. Because this will have a significant impact on your part two response, which in turn will greatly impact part three, which is connected to part two. Okay. So that should make sense, all right? So everybody's like, yeah, okay. And Rajveer says, yeah, part three totally depends on it. So anybody that has taken the IELTS knows that part three very much depends on your performance in part two. So part two is critical, okay? So step one, yeah, a lot of you said for step one, I remember said, read the question, okay? And Baekjun's saying, read it twice. Yeah, so I'm going to kind of outline this a little bit more granular, a little bit more detail. So step one, take a deep breath and remember not to rush and use the full minute. Okay. 60 seconds is ample time as long as you remain calm and focused. So interestingly, members, students, 1 minute is very, very short amount of time if you're panicking, if you're freaking out, if you're stressing, if you're nervous. 1 minute goes by in the blink of an eye, okay? But if you're really calm and you're focused, then 1 minute can be much more lengthy and very well used, okay? Keep that in mind. So step one is just to simply stay calm. And then, of course, as many of you are saying, read the question carefully, especially the topic sentence, which you should read twice, just to make sure that you do not speak off topic. Okay, that's actually one of the most common mistakes, speaking off topic. And when students speak off topic in part two, that is disaster. Okay, so you must avoid that at all cost. Okay, you must avoid going off topic. So here we go. Part two, cue card, you turn it over, you stay calm, you take a deep breath, and you read. Talk about where it is good to meet new people. Okay, one more time. Talk about where it is good to meet new people. So it's a general statement, general question, okay? Meeting new people. Where is it and what does it look like? So we're talking about a location, where it's located geographically, physically, and its appearance, obviously. Who goes there? Okay, no surprise there, right? The topic is a location. So its appearance, its location, and the attendees. Okay, what activities happen there? So what do people do there? And then, of course, why is it a good place to meet people? And how does this happen? So how does meeting new people happen at this place? You will have 1 to 2 minutes to talk about this topic. So good, you read it, you're clear on it, you're ready to go to step two. And again, you have lots of time in the 60 seconds to do this, as long as you stay course, okay? So step two, you don't need to write these down in the real exam, just remember them, okay? Topic is a place. Place, as the card clearly indicates, needs its location, its appearance. Now, maybe a point that's not on the card, but you might add a sentence in, is the history, right? What's the background to it? The attendees, the activities, and your opinion. And in this case, your opinion is basically, you can think about it like the last question or two on the card, okay? And in that order, all right? Yashin, welcome to our group of members. It's really cool that you joined. Send me an email, I'll send you your perks, okay? Rajveer, nice. So you're going with me here. You're identifying the category, its location. You're identifying the tense, its present tense. There you are, Yasin. Hi, it's great. And you're already in the chat, fantastic. Baekjun says, the purpose. Yeah, purpose of the place, Baekjun, is like the activities. It's better to kind of think of the activities that happen there. I suppose purpose could be a little bit different, Baekjun, more like your opinion or that last question, right? You're definitely on the right track. Okay, what's the next step? This is the one many students forget, even though I go through it every class, and I think sometimes students are like, yeah, we know, but you got to remember this one, okay? This is crucial. So today's theme, of course, as I introduced the class right at the top there, is more bands, okay? Now, more bands in your speaking section, so far I've said use that 1 minute preparation time in part two wisely. That will get you more bands. And within that, this is one of the, or this is arguably the most important step to get better bands, okay? So Rajveer says, come up with 2 to 3 such places. Very good, Rajveer. I like your attention to detail. Baekjun says, think of ideas. Samuel says, 2 to 3 ideas. Okay. Jainil says, 2 to 3 topics. Okay. Good. So that's what we're thinking of. And I see some of you already talking here. So Baekjun says, public parks. Okay. Now, when you're doing this, students, visualize. Think of where you have started conversation with new people. So visualize and think of where you have started conversation with new people. Think of where did you meet your friends? Okay, so think about that, all right? So it will be easier to talk about it, right? Public parks, cafe. Rajveer says gymnasium. I really like that one. Cafe, gym. Yeah. Samuel says tennis court. Sammy says wedding party. Okay, careful. Wedding party is an event, Samuel. Okay. So sports center, I'm liking that one. Janiel says science fair. Okay, science fair is also an event. All right. Careful with event versus location. That could be tricky here. Pub or dance club? Sure, that's possible as well, Carolina. Absolutely. Okay. And Samuel says restaurant. Okay, all right. All right, so we have some good ones here. Now, of course, keeping in mind it should be easy to talk about, and it should be somewhat unique, so somewhat to yourself. So Sammy says church as well, religious places. Yeah, Sammy, I think that's good. I'm going to avoid that for today's discussion, but yeah, I think those are good as well. Ashraf says the beach. Yeah, I think that's a good one too. Let's write that down. Okay. All right, so we have lots of ideas. You really only need to think about three, okay? And then choose the best one. So let's number these. One, public park. Two, cafe. Three, gym. Four, wedding party. Five, science fair. Six, pub. Seven, dance club. Eight, restaurant. Nine, beach. Okay, I'm going to take out number four and number five because these are events, okay? It's not a location, but rather an event. These ones are okay. They might be a little bit tricky to talk about. So I would recommend somewhere around these numbers here. What do you think? All right. So we have some votes for seven. We have votes for three, two as well, a cafe. Cafes are interesting. We sometimes meet people there, but I actually find that we don't often meet friends at cafes. We just kind of talk with people briefly. I think let's go with gym. It looks like that's a popular vote, and I'm sure all of us have been to the gym at one point in time or another. And I think if we're visualizing this, okay, so which one should I choose when you're thinking of this important question? Now, for those of you who have never been to the gym, perhaps this might be a little bit tricky, but for those of you that have, I think you'll realize that, oh yeah, that one would be quite a nice topic to choose. So which one should I choose? What you should do is visualize. Okay, visualize yourself at the gym. And I think that if you're doing that, a lot of you are realizing like, yeah, there's a lot of reasons and ways to begin conversation at a gym and to meet new people. Okay, there's a lot of possibility there. So let's go with the gym. Okay. And now our next step is to write down or jot down, let's say, a few useful notes following the order described in step two. Okay, that's another really important point to get the higher band scores. So don't just write down your notes in a random fashion. Okay, so don't just randomly start writing down all kinds of ideas that pop into mind, but organize your thoughts. Okay, I love how Abhishek's already got the names of the gyms coming up. Yeah, Gold's Gym. It's one of the most famous ones in the world, so we'll just go with that one. Okay, location. Delhi Fitness Center, Fitness Club Center. Yeah, lots of ones that we can go with their students. So location, okay? I'll give you one here. Broad Street, Vancouver, downtown. I'm not actually sure if there's a Gold's Gym there, but we'll go with that. Okay. All right. So give me a little bit of information. What should I write down next in my notes? Okay. So go through those five different points when talking about a place. In your mind, these should be really clear. You should practice all of these before your exam. Of course, not just for places, but people, events, ideas, and such as well. Okay, Bumi says maybe a little bit more here, 5 km away. We'll just do 5 km. We know what that's about. Okay, Abhishek says 24/7. That's fine. Not yet the working hours and the distance and the attendees. A little bit before that. This is the point that many people forget. So it's co-ed, sure, it's for men and women. Okay, that's fine. So Hina says, maybe the facilities that they offer. Yeah, Hina, you're on the right track. So this is the one that a lot of people forget. So location is one, and the one people tend to forget is the appearance. Okay, this is another really important point for objects, people, places, to talk about the appearance. Okay, so a little bit on the appearance. I'm always amazed how people ignore talking about the appearance. So I'm going to make a note here for everyone in the notes. Note in the notes. Okay, so do not forget to quickly say a couple sentences about the appearance when describing a place, person, or object. Okay, this is super important for a few reasons. And interestingly, this element, if you get a place or an object or a person for your cue card, is not just important for your cue card and your part three, but it's even important for your task one, task two writing. Why is that? What is so important about saying a couple sentences to describe what a person looks like, or what a place looks like, or what an object looks like? Why is that so important, members? Why am I so adamant and ambitious that you remember this this important piece of information here? Okay, and I see that, you know, you have some information, you have great information in the chat there for the appearance. So why is that so important? So Carolina says, because it adds context. And Baekjun says, because it helps the examiner to imagine. And you're absolutely right. It creates context and visual information for your audience. Okay, in this case, your examiner. It is the most clear indication that the speaker, or in task two, you could say the writer, is presenting from an audience perspective and not a versus self perspective. Okay? As humans, we tend to commonly make this mistake to speak to others like as if we're speaking to a mirror image of ourselves. And that image has some key pieces of information in their head, which makes the information clear. But you have to remember that that's not the case. Just think of all the really nice books that you've read in your life and the beautiful descriptive language used in those books or magazine articles or even brief internet articles that help you to imagine and empathize with the context, okay? Humans are visual creatures. Remember, our eyeballs are arguably our most important body part for our senses. So you have to keep that in mind, okay? So it's not just to add more info, Hina. It's much more importantly to give context, okay? To have your audience realize like, hey, this person is thinking about me when they're speaking to me. Or, hey, this person is thinking about me when they're writing to me. They're not thinking about themselves, okay? Super important, all right? So that's why. So well said, Carolina and Baekjun, about context and imagination, okay? Of course, it will help vocabulary and everything else along with it, right? So a lot of good components come together. All right, so Abhishek says, well, okay, let's do this. So it's 10,000 square feet of exercise space, two floors, juice bar, change rooms, showers, many cardio machines, free weights, CrossFit, it's the popular ones these days, training, it might be one word, CrossFit, yoga room. Sure, lots of those will come to mind, okay? Yeah, nice, so lots and lots of great information there, okay? So, bright colors, windows, all right, fantastic. So now we have context, okay? So just a couple sentences and we have a lot of great context. Okay, Pavan says motivational music, great. Sure, nice, Pavan. So those are the good ideas. These are our usable notes, okay? All right, so again, history, you might say something like, it's been around for at least 20 years, okay? You don't need to say a lot more for this one, so 20 years. All right, and now let's go to the attendees, okay? So Hina, I think you're on it. Great staff. Personal trainers. Okay. Rajveer says, men, women. Sure. What can we say a little bit more, Rajveer, than just men and women? Because it's clear that men and women will go to this gym. So can we say a little bit more about the people that go there that will help you to talk about meeting new people? Of course, always keep in mind the topic here, right? The controlling idea. We're a place where we're meeting new people, right? So... very good, Abhishek. So Abhishek's saying, let's go a little bit deeper. So businessmen, businesswomen, students, okay? So, very nice, okay. Okay, Samuel says 20s to 50s. Okay, sure, good. So age, right? 20s. To 50s, don't limit it to just 20s. I would say 20s to 50s years old, right? Good. Okay, and people who go to the gym, what's kind of a commonality among them? Okay, so why is the gym particularly a good place? Okay, so they're probably fit, ambitious, okay, full of energy. All right. And how do you meet new people? So now let's go to the activities. And of course, we'll remember lots of them, right? So workout, aerobics, cardio, sure, okay. But how do you meet them? So you want to keep that in mind. So how do you meet new people in the gym? Why is it a good place to meet new people? And how do you meet them? Visualize that very quickly. This is all happening in that 1 minute. Okay, Ashraf says there's Zumba class. Very good, sure. Okay. How would you meet a new person in the gym? So how would you start a conversation? Yeah, so Samuel says discuss diets, discuss exercise routines. So discuss diet, exercise routine. Okay. What else? So Sammy says, just spark up a conversation while exercising. Sure, Sammy, and maybe it's about their diet, okay? Yeah, so Pavan says, treadmill. Now, Pavan, I get what you're saying. You're right next to the person. Even if they're running twice as fast as you, you're still beside each other for that 10, 20 minutes, right? So close proximity, treadmill. Sure, very good. Yeah, treadmill, for those of you who aren't clear, it's the running machine that you run on. Okay, very good, Ashraf. That's what I was looking for, to ask for assistance. Yeah, exactly, Jainil. So you ask people to help you during the exercise, right? So, ask for assistance. And I'm sure many of you remember the first time that you visited a gym, not just to help lift the weights, but also for information, right? Okay, you've got lots of great information now, right? So one more time here, members, this is hopefully what's being born in your mind in that 1 minute preparation time. I guarantee you, if you get this cue card, if you think of a few ideas, you come up with gym, you go through these steps nice and quick, you jot down a few of these notes, you are looking great. Okay, would you agree with me? That if you have this information on your card or on your notepaper in the 1 minute, you're feeling quite confident going into your 2 minute response time, right? So at this point, you're feeling pretty good. When the examiner says, okay, you have 2 minutes to speak, it begins now. You're going, ho ho, I'm on it, right? Okay, good. So I can see a lot of you are like, yeah, yeah, yeah. Hope Carolina, you're still here as well. Okay, cool. So next step, real quick, just before that 1 minute is up, I believe we're into step five here, is your first sentence. So give me the first sentence, and you can literally just use the first sentence of the card question and your first couple notes to answer that first sentence. Okay, yeah, cool, there's Carolina. Carolina's like, yes, I'm still here. Cool. Okay. So your first sentence, let's get into it. So talk about a place where it is good to meet new people. So talk about a place where it is good to meet new people. All right. So Beck Jones says, I think the best and common place to meet new individuals is the gym, which is situated just a kilometer from my apartment on Broad Street. Beautiful, Beck John. That is a fantastic start. Okay, you're on the right track. Okay, right to the point, very clear. You're answering the card. Sammy says, I usually meet new people at the gym. Very good. Now, Sammy, this isn't necessarily about you, but sure, you can. It doesn't say you can't. It can't be about you, so it's fine. Samuel says, of all the places to visit, I find that gyms are the best to meet new people. Okay, good, Samuel. Yeah, of all the places I visit, I find gyms are the best. You don't need to say places twice, Samuel. It's good. Rajveer says, a great place to meet fresh faces is at the gymnasium. Yeah, gymnasium, Rajveer, in Canadian English anyway, means like the gymnasium at a school, which is like a large auditorium where you can play sports like basketball. So what we're discussing here is more of a fitness gym. Although, Rajveer, I'm not sure, maybe in Britain or the US, gymnasium also refers to the fitness gym. I'd have to check that. I'm not sure. In Canada, we use gymnasium more for the bigger space, the auditorium where you can play indoor basketball, volleyball, and so on. So check that out. Okay, Hina says, a great place which comes to mind is the gym, where it's a good place to meet with new people. Hina, that's good. Definitely a few grammar mistakes there. Careful not to unnecessarily overcomplicate your first sentence. So, Hina, keep your first sentence simple and clear. Okay. Pavan says, being gregarious, I would like to meet fresh faces at the gym, which is 5 kilometers from my place. Nice, Pavan. Abhishek, I believe Gold's Gym is one of the best places to meet new personalities, which is 5 blocks from my flat. Abhishek, that works well. Bumi, keeping it simple and beautiful. Bumi says, a perfect place to meet new individuals is the local gym. Yeah, very nice. Welcome, Sebastian, to our group of members. Good to see you. Carolina says, a place which I often meet new people at is a gym called Gold's Gym about 5 kilometers from my home. Very nice. Yasin, jumping in. Fantastic. The best place to meet with new people is the gym, even if you live in Ireland and have perfect pubs. All right, Yasin. Yeah. Okay, good. So, first sentence. A fantastic place to meet fresh faces. I liked that use of idiomatic language. I think that was Rajveer. Is a fitness gym. Like Gold's Gym, which is located about 5K from my house on Broad Street, downtown Vancouver. Okay, good, nice. So the examiner says, your 1 minute preparation time is up. Please begin speaking. You look up, you're feeling good, and you start with, repeat after me, students. A fantastic place to meet fresh faces is a fitness gym like Gold's Gym, which is located about 5K from my house on Broad Street, downtown Vancouver. Okay, you're off to a good start. Let's keep going here. So now, of course, we're going into appearance. Okay, so let's give a little bit of context. What does this gym look like, right? Baekjun's on it, rolling with it. Good, Baekjun. So Baekjun says, this bright gym's named Astana. It has 2 floors with 1,000 square meters and is equipped with the latest training machines such as treadmills, weights, and horizontal bars. Really nice. In this response, Baekjun, you're picking up lots of lexical resource points. Lexical resource points are just ding, 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 ding. Band 8, band 9, band 9, band 9. Okay, so beautiful. Samuel says it is a 2-story building with ample space for people to work out since it's one of the largest gyms in the city with a wide range of equipment with additional facilities like yoga classes and, of course, daily Zumba sessions. Same thing, Samuel. Really nice answer. You're checking off all kinds of high band descriptors in the IELTS exam when you say that. There's Sebastian. Hi, Sebastian. Yeah, of course, Sebastian, get in there. So Sebastian says, our local gym is known to be a place for meeting new people. Sebastian, when I'm correcting, and for other students as well, you can always check the time and go back and see what I did to make it more natural and just repeat a couple times. Okay. Pavan says, I like the fact that it covers 1,000 square meters. To energize with motivational music, machines such as treadmills, weights, and horizontal bars. Very nice, students. So this particular gym is about 10,000 square feet of bright space filled with a range of cardio machines as well as free weights and some open floor space for yoga and Zumba classes. Of course, there are change rooms with showers and even a juice bar that serves all types of protein shakes and health bars. All right, again, creating that visual context, you're picking up tons of vocabulary and you're rolling along, okay? All right, so more coming up. Rajveer says it's built on a 10,000 square foot area, has two floors. There are a wide range of equipment like treadmills, CrossFit, and double along with a big 50-inch Sony Bravia screen to entertain while you're taking a rest between exercises. Good, Rajveer, very nice. Okay. Sebastian, good, thanks for confirming. Fantastic. Sammy says, it is located on the second floor with 2,000 square feet, different kinds of equipment, a large TV with a change room, and attracts people with comfort. Okay, Sammy, a couple of corrections there, but I get where you're going with it. Okay, good. Now, let's keep going here. So, I think it's been around for the past 20 years or so. Okay, so just a quick, that was a super fast little bit on history. That gives me the ability to put some present perfect in there as well. I think it's been around. The it's here is it has. Okay, I think it has been around for the past 20 years or so. So I think it's been around for the past 20 years or so. So that's all you need here for the history. The card's not asking for more history. So I'm just going to put that in there. And then we get into attendees, people that go there. And look at you clever students that are now getting used to these classes and this flow of information. So Samuel says people from different age groups, ranging from teenagers to granddads, try to get in shape, get emotionally sound. The gym plays some punchy music to heighten the mood. Very good, Samuel. I like where you're going with it. It's creating more visual imagery in my mind. Bekjan says this place is usually visited by those who are age 20s, like businessmen, sporty people, celebrities, since it's important for them to keep in shape. Very good, Bekjan. Samuel says, people from different age groups. Oh, yeah, I see that. So it's kind of a repeat there. Pavan says, I get the lush feeling with all the commodities provided by the gym. I wonder if it's a gym or a fantasy world. Pavan, I think you're going off topic there. Okay. So now the gym is frequented by a wide range of people and ages, businessmen, businesswomen, students, people, ages, into retirement. All of these patrons share a love for physical fitness and tend to be ambitious and positive individuals. Okay, good. All right. So attendees, right? Attendees here is very important because we're talking about a place where it's good to meet new people. All right. So Hina says people come to this place with great motivation to achieve their goals. Very good, Hina. So you're on the same track as well. Okay. Pavan says colleagues and celebrities. Nice. Sammy says many different people like students, businessmen, also celebrities come and work out on their bodies to maintain their fitness. The gym's open 24/7. I can go there anytime. Rajvir says generally businessmen, women and men and students ages 20 to 50 go there to stay in shape and maintain their cardiovascular health. Good. Okay, let's talk about activities plus the way it is good to meet new people. So give me this information. Okay, give me this information now. All right, so keep the card in mind. Okay, students, members, viewers, always keep the card in mind. You always want to circle back to the controlling idea and the topic, okay? So Baekjun says, as the name implies, people engage in different activities, such as, okay, keep going here. All right, so, of course, there are many ways to stay fit at the gym, whether it's doing CrossFit, joining in on a yoga class, or doing some free weights. There are lots of opportunities to strike up a conversation. I can't remember who keeps saying the strike up a conversation, but this is a great place to use it, to strike up a conversation. Since everyone at the gym is new at some point, people often ask each other for information about how to use certain equipment. A lady the other day asked me to help set up the program on her treadmill. On the same day, about 30 minutes after, a college student requested me to spot him for his final set on the bench press. Okay, now if you don't know some of that vocabulary, that's totally fine. Okay, use what you know, visualize, and say it, okay? All right, Baekjun says, while doing activities, attendees can ask each other about the facilities and strike up conversation. Very good, Baekjun. All right, so this is where you can check your notes as well. We have lots of information in our notes also. Okay. Let's see, keep going, students, keep coming up with how you meet people there. In addition, when I stop to catch my breath, it is often a good idea, or it is often fun to chit chat with others at the juice bar or lounge about their day, as they too are taking a short breather. I'm throwing some new vocabulary at you here as well, members, so make sure to note those later on, okay? All right. So Samuel says people usually strike up a conversation on diets that they follow, exercise routines that they do at home. Since people visit gyms often, they have the same goals of toning their bodies. It's a great place to socialize with people as they're novices entering the gym every week. And all they need is a little motivation and help to make correct use of the equipment. Beautiful speaking, Samuel. Excellent. Well done. Okay. And that's another point. If you're doing some really good critical thinking, you realize furthermore, the same people return to the gym time and again at the same time of the day. So it gives way to becoming familiar with those who share exercise schedules and routines, right? And I'm sure many of you who have been at the gym realize that yeah, wait a second, I go to the gym and I see the same guy, the same girl, again and again and again at the same time. We're trying to use the same machine. So you can't avoid but to start a conversation at some point. That's something that you can't really do at pubs or other places. I mean, yeah, sure, there are some pubs where it's the same people that go again and again, but the gym is definitely consistent. Okay, everyone, we've done a fantastic job, and I'm sure many of you have some great ideas. Let's go through this together, make sure that we're answering the card and we're doing a good job. But again, give yourselves a pat on the back. Everybody has done a fantastic job today, I think. So let's go from the top. Here we go. Just speak and repeat. A fantastic place to meet fresh faces is a fitness gym like Gold's Gym, which is located about 5K from my house on Broad Street, downtown Vancouver. This particular gym is about 10,000 square feet of bright space filled with a range of cardio machines as well as free weights and some open floor space for yoga and Zumba classes. Of course, there are change rooms with showers and even a juice bar that serves all types of protein shakes and health bars. I think it's been around for the past 20 years or so. The gym is frequented by a wide range of people and ages, businessmen, businesswomen, students, people ages 20 to well into retirement. All of these patrons share a love for physical fitness and tend to be ambitious and positive individuals. Of course, there are many ways to stay fit at the gym, whether it's doing CrossFit, joining a yoga class, or doing some free weights. There are lots of opportunities to strike up a conversation. Since everyone at the gym is new at some point, people often ask each other for information about how to use certain equipment. A lady the other day asked me to help set up the program on her treadmill. On the same day, about 30 minutes after, a college student requested me to spot him for his final set on the bench press. In addition, when I stop to catch my breath, it's often fun to chit-chat with others at the juice bar or lounge about their day as they too are taking a short breather. Furthermore, the same people return to the gym time and again at the same time of the day, so it gives way to becoming familiar with those who share exercise schedules and routines. Definitely, the gym is one of the best places to meet with good people. And your 2 minutes is up. Now we will continue with part three. Part three will be connected to part two. How good are you feeling about part three right now? So how good, not part two, but how good are you feeling about going into a topic in part three, members? Okay, tell me that. So you just gave a response or a response that's similar to this. How good are you feeling about, or how confident are you feeling about part three at this point, knowing that you're going to be asked some questions related to the topic of part two? So Samuel says, excited. Carolina says, I'm feeling great. Ashraf says, satisfactory. Absolutely. And you should be. Okay. So again, going back to today's topic, students, really importantly, okay, from top down here one more time. All right. And today's topic, of course, for the lesson was to get more bands in part two, but also to get more bands in part three, right? So what did I emphasize in this class? Number one, the most important 1 minute in your interview, ironically, is your 1 minute preparation time for the cue card, okay? Why? Because when you come up with a great idea, then you will be set for part two and part three. You need to take a deep breath. Don't rush. Stay calm in that 1 minute. Okay? Very importantly, think about two or three different possible answers and choose the best one. That's really, really important. And then don't forget to add some description of the appearance when talking about a person, a place, or an object. Give your listener, give your audience context. All right, members, fantastic job in today's class. Really, you were brilliant, and you should be excited going into part three. We will be going into part three in 30 minutes. So I will be back in 30 minutes with part three, which will be questions related to the topic of part two. You're very welcome, Rajveer. You're welcome, Sammy Hina. Nice participation. Welcome to our two new members. It's great to have you on board. Please send me an email so I can hook you up with your perks. Thank you so much for being with me right now. There's Yasin. That's great. And hopefully I will catch you in half an hour for some more. Bye for now. I'm Adrian, signing out from Budapest.